What's up, YouTube? Bottles and Ball Cards back with another video. It's Wednesday, week's half over. I hope you all are doing well. I hope the week has been treating you good. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't, subscribe, hit the notification bell. And of course, comment down below. Let me know your thoughts. I know this is going to be probably mixed opinions, and that's perfectly fine. I'll also say there's only one example in this video, but I wanted to use this example because I wanted to just kind of show how it's easy to look at a graph and try to tell somebody something, but the graph doesn't always tell the full story. And there are some folks out there that have obviously a much, much, much larger audience than I do. They have people that listen to them much more than any advice or whatever that I try to share, which is perfectly fine. But people, if we're going to educate folks, or if we're going to try to help the hobby, if we want this hobby to grow and thrive and be built upon and people to enjoy themselves and not just take gambles, take risks, and lose money and get discouraged and move on, then we have to share this kind of thing. And so, again, it's not going to be accepted or, you know, whatever. It's going to be argued by some, I already know, but I wanted to share this anyway. So, in this video, this is Jeff Wilson's Sports Card Investor. He did a video called 7 Sneaky Ways to Profit on Sports Cards. Number 3 way is to buy cards, and he specifically states, and again, I want to make this disclosure, this is not anything to do with specifically SGC. He mentions SGC and CSG. However, in the video, he does use a SGC 10 card, so that's what I'm going to be speaking on, showing examples and why his theory can actually make you lose money and not gain money. So this has nothing to do with SGC specifically because he does mention CSG. I just want to disclose that before anybody says, well, Bobble's your pro SGC, you're an SGC submitter. I would show the same thing if I came across this and knew, you know, hey, this doesn't make any sense. But anyway, what he's doing in this video, he's using an SGC 10 Anthony Edwards Prism Silver, and he's telling you to crack it out and send it in to PSA. Now, his argument is SGC and CSG, he also mentioned CSG, he said they're good to crack out and send to PSA because they are notoriously tougher graders, is what he says. Now, I prefer to say they are more accurate and they have a broader scale because they have the 9.5, whereas PSA is lenient and bumps more cards to 10s because they don't have a 9.5. They don't have anything that fits in that 9.5 range. So it's the grader's opinion, is it a 9 or is it a 10? I think many times in this 46% that some of those 10s probably could have fit an in-between. They could have been a tweener card. Or it was just a matter of a coin flip of whether the grader said, okay, I'll give this one a 10 or I'll do this one as a 9. So, you know, look at the rate, 46%. It's almost 50-50. So his theory is buy CSG and SGC 10s and send them to PSA and you can make money. That's his 7 sneaky ways to profit on sports cards. You can make money. Now, I want to share something. So first off, go in here and I will let you see his chart just so I'm not making anything up. Anthony Edwards, Prism Silver, SGC 10. He says is $800. Where does it show the PSA? And it says the PSA is $11,1250. All right. This is on April 22nd, and the SGC sale shows April 23rd. All right, so we're going to go, and I have the PSA 10, I have the SGC 10 here. So we can see here, this is already under value of what he's showing you guys. So that's one. And then the SGC, there was an April 18th sale here. And then here is April 23rd at $800. So that matches up. All right. I just wanted to confirm that. Well, what he's trying to say in his thing is that you can grade cards with PSA now for $50. So before we jump into this, I want to show for $50, it's a $9.99 max declared value. But over here, he's telling you that it's worth, where did it go? Right here, 11.12. So you're actually over that $1,000 declared value. Does PSA let it slide? I cannot comment on that. I'm just telling you what the chart says. If they are using market movers pricing or card ladder pricing and going based off of the current market data for that time, and this card was an $1,100 card, you're not getting it graded for 50 bucks. You're going to have to pay 100. So, Jeff, there is step number one with your inaccuracy. All right, now we obviously know that if you send the card in, you bought it, you had to wait to get it, then you do your submission, you crack it out, you do your submission to PSA. I hate to tell you, it's not gonna be like they're back done and back to you the same day to where you can get it back up on eBay, right? We know market changes, market fluctuates. I don't know when the hell he recorded this video, but he uploaded it on May 1st. So I'm going to Terapeak, and first I want to show, just so everybody can see, there has not been another SGC10 sale. Here is the one right here, April 24th, $800 with 475 shipping. Well, let's go over and look at some PSA sales now. So PSA, there is 899 was the last sale on May 3rd, okay? Think about that a second. Just without me even going into any details, it was $800 to buy the SGC10. I just stated and showed you, if you valued it at $1,100 or whatever, it would be $100 a card. That's already $900. If you sell the card today, it brings $900. All right? It's easy to show a graph and show a sale that stands out, and that's something people need to pay attention to, because just because that sale was all flashy and on his screen to make it look like this great idea, it was a little gap right here, a little section here where they're over 1,000. But look, 987, 977. You got over 1,000 here. That's an autograph. 908, 910, 860, 865, 969, 899. So that $800 sale on the SGC10. Now, let's go look at let just go look at some numbers. So if you sold the SGC10 for $800, okay, after eBay fees, and I also included in your grading cost, for the 800, your profit should have been around $700. Tossing the grading, you would have cleared about 670 net, give or take on how much your eBay fees cost you. I always use like a 12.5%, just as that's normally what stuff was factoring out to. It might be a little bit less than that now, because I think the fees went up slightly. But anyway, just for a rough estimate, and I based both on 12.5%, so you'll get a clear picture. But 670 profit after eBay fees and grading. So let's jump over to the PSA 10 now. So let's say you bought this 804.75. Okay, that's your cost right here, 804, and I'm not even doing taxes because some people are tax exempt. So 804.75, add in the $100 grading fee, All right, because we're going to have to do this as 100 if we're sending it in with the assumption that this is an $1,100 card, as Jeff Wilson told us that it is. It's an $1,125 card. We can make $200 to $300. Jeff Wilson told us so. So we got a $100 grading fee. Then you got to add in your shipping to and from PSA, because he doesn't mention this, but the United States Postal Service does not send that ship for free. All right, and PSA is going to charge you to ship it back to you. So I did an approximately $40 on this. You know, they insure shipping on the return. It varies, but I'm going to say $40 to and from, depending on what service you take, right? And to get it back quicker, you make sure you get that thing back quick. All right, so you're going to be at $944.75. All right, that's your all-in cost, all-inclusive. $804.75 plus 100 grading plus $40 shipping, we're going to be looking at $944.75. So current sale value, if the card was returned today, we put it on eBay, we did $899.99. Again, let me refresh you here. Over here, $899.99 was the last sale, May 3rd. Going over here, there was another one, but it's not showing up for May 4th yet. So I don't have that over here in the research, but as you can see, it was $1,000 or best offer, so you know, it was less than $1,000 either way. But we go here, $899, that's what we're going to use. So $899, so after your eBay fees, you're looking at $787.49. so in theory, you sold this card and would have cleared better than the SGC-10, right? That's the brain thought that is being tossed out there to people. Well, it sells for more. But remember, you have this involved with it, right? So, what are you making on selling this PSA 10 using Jeff Wilson's theory, telling you to buy an SGC-10, crack it out, send it to PSA, and sell it? What are you going to make on this card? You are going to lose $157.26. You are not making a freaking dime, people. Do your own research. Realize these markets transition so much. Be happy with a profit. Okay? Be happy with a profit. This is a loss. This is a loss. The product research is right here, okay? You sold it there. Now, granted, if one popped up today and you could get it for $600, maybe in an SGC 10 or whatever, okay, fine. But you still, you know, you got to do all of the math. There's shipping involved to and from PSA. There is the risk factor involved. Do you get the 10 or do you get a 9? If you get the 9, you know, what the hell is a PSA 9 going for? Let's look at that, because that's another risk aversion. $200. You buy, let's say the SGC 10 is $600. You send it in and PSA is like, nope, it's a 9. Well, now you freaking lost even more. Okay? It's not as simple as this. All right? It's just not. Think about things, do the math, do your own research, stop believing this sneaky arbitrage bullcrap, because it's not as great as it sounds. That's all I got for you guys today. Give the video a thumbs up if you like this, if you thought it helped you. Comment down below, let me know your thoughts. As always, folks, stay safe, stay healthy, and until the next video, I'm out.